There's a device that I've been using called a Whoop.
Hello, and welcome back to IGOW, International Game of Whoop. We're on week number 14, and Halloween is this week, so we had a little fun naming the trick, and it's going to be called Spooky Spins, also known as Inverted Orbit. So we'll get into the weekly requirements in a minute, but first I want to go over some exciting sponsor and prize information. First, I want to announce that Beta FPV has generously donated at least 10 more weeks of $5 gift cards. So the winners through weeks at least 13 through 22 will also get a $5 gift card. Thanks, Beta FPV. Also, the tinywhoop.com weekly sponsored prize is going to be 2 free frames this week. So you get to pick any 2 Whoop frames off the tinywhoop.com website. Finally, I want to announce that we're welcoming aboard a new sponsor, and that is Tuner RC. Tuner RC is an FPV company that makes battery chargers, and right now their signature product is the Thor 2S Balance Charger. If you want to know more about the Thor 2S Balance Charger, check out my video that's going to come out later today explaining what it is and how it works. Right now is a great time because Tuner RC is running a promotion where if you use the discount code in the description below, you'll not only get 15% off, but you also get your charger customized. It'll have a special Halloween graphic, and you get your name or your pilot name engraved on the charger as well. That's pretty awesome. And one lucky entry will be selected at random this week, and that pilot will get a custom Thor charger with the IGOW logo and their name or their pilot name. That's super awesome. I'm excited to see that. Wow, so much great prize and sponsor update information. And stay tuned in the following weeks because there are going to be even more. So I hope you all remember week number one, and that was the standard orbit where our drone is facing the POI like this, and we circle around it facing the POI the whole time. This week is similar in that you're going to be circling around an object, but this time the back of your drone is going to be facing the object, and your camera is going to be looking up at whatever's at the top of it. So then you're going to cycle around backwards this time while looking up the whole time, and that is an inverted orbit. So let's go over the weekly requirements. Requirement number one is that you complete 3 complete orbits in both directions. So you have to do 3 counterclockwise inverted orbits and 3 clockwise inverted orbits to avoid a letter this week. Now, most everyone has a preferred direction, so I think that learning one direction is going to be a lot easier than the other. Requirement number two is that, just like week number one, you keep whatever the top of the POI is in frame the whole time during your 3 orbits. Requirement number 3 is a little bit difficult to explain, so I'm going to try to do it, and you pretend that the screen here is the FPV view. So ideally, your pole or whatever is supporting your POI will stay in the top of the FPV view the entire time while you're orbiting, because that would make it a true inverted orbit. But we're not going to be that picky this week. If you do happen to have the pole dip down to the corner, that is going to be still acceptable. But if you go down to the side of the FPV view, then you have to make sure that the pole never gets to 90 degrees, because that becomes a knife edge orbit at that point. So during your 3 orbits, at some point during all 3 orbits, you have to have the pole in the top of the view at some point during one point of each 3 orbits. And again, if you dip down and have the pole coming out of the side of the FPV view for part of the orbit, that's fine, as long as you never make it to 90 degrees or past and turn your orbit into a knife edge orbit instead of a spooky spin. If you've never tried an inverted orbit before, it might seem pretty intimidating, but it's really not that hard. It's just about learning where your sticks need to go to get yourself locked into the orbit. So I suggest watching some tutorials on the internet, because there's lots of good ones out there, and giving it a try for yourself, maybe in the simulator before real life, just so you get the feel of how it works. I'd never tried this trick before 2 days ago, and I think I did some pretty decent spooky spins that you've seen here. They're obviously not perfect, but I would say they're passable. Anyway, hope you guys have fun trying these Halloween-themed spooky spins this week, and get out there and learn some new tricks. Happy whooping!
Public enemy, why you wanna go and do me like that? Come down on the street and dance.